Hi everybody, it's Michelle and I am back to show you guys how I am using my LG PoPo printer in my bullet journal. Let me start by saying I have some shadowing in this video, which is kind of distracting to me because I'm not used to it, but I had to turn off my overhead light because the glare was so bad on my phone that was even worse as far as being a distraction. So hopefully this will turn out well, once I get the phone turned on, and it won't be a big deal. But this is the printer here, and I ordered it from a company in Korea, and I ordered it through Amazon, and it came pretty quick. And it come in the pink, yellow, and white, and I'll link to all of that below, either to the actual place on Amazon or to a blog post, and so the information will be below. It came in a box like this, and I saved the box because I store my extra paper in here. And I actually use Polaroid Pogo paper in my printer instead of the LG paper because this is cheaper and I like to buy it in bulk, and it has the adhesive backing on it, so I just peel off the back and stick it in my book like a sticker. This card here, every package of paper comes with one of these cards, and it calibrates the printer. So every time you put in a new package, this runs through and calibrates the printer. I saved this from one of my packages with the LG paper, which I have one here. Nope, that's not it. It's here. LG paper. So this one came out of a LG paper package, and I use this for all the calibration. So every time I open up a new one of these packages, I throw away the blue card in here, and I use this one to calibrate the printer, just to be sure that it works correctly, and I don't get any errors, because sometimes you might get an error if you try to use the one that's actually in the package with the Pogo paper. So I just store that all the way there, and like I said, I will put the links to this below. This is what it looks like. And she sends a sweet note with that. Okay. So I use it almost every day, at least 5 times a week probably. And what I do, in the beginning of my book here, there aren't as many pictures because I was still using my Hobonichi to put most of my pictures in. But when something happens during the day, I like to take snapshots and stick those in here of things that, just to jog my memory. These are actually on the printer, so I'm not going to show those. But, you know, like a graduation ceremony, these were when I was working on my house, some before and after pictures, so that was good for that, for all the before and after stuff, so I don't forget what it looked like before. When we went to the movies, cleaning at my desk, how my desk looked after I cleaned it. So items that I make and put in the shops, I take pictures of usually and put them in. The kids playing outside. Just projects that I was working on. My granddaughter with her new Lala Loopsie doll. Blankets and patterns that I'm working on. Pictures of those. Holidays. Beach outings. Another blanket pattern that I'm working on, or that I did work on. That one's done. Another blanket pattern. Family holidays. Things going on. So it's just a great way to add pictures to your journal. Even if you're not using it in a journal, they print out this size in a 2x3, and it's perfect to fit into like the business card holder in a Filofax, the Filofax sheets, or to put in your wallets. And you can just print them out directly from your phone, because almost everybody uses their phones now to take pictures. And you can just print it directly from here and put it wherever you want it. So I'm going to show you how I do that now. The printer receives the transmissions from the phone either through Bluetooth or NFC, which if you have a Samsung phone, you know they have NFC built in. And I believe the newest iPhones might have it also. That's how you do that swipe and pay, and it's NFC technology. And even if you don't have that, you can set up a Bluetooth connection to print out the pictures. So it's all wireless. You charge this. Here's a charging port right here. You can connect it to your computer to charge it, or to a wall plug. Either one. Once it's charged, you just take it with you, throw it in your purse or your bag, and you're good to go. So let's see what this looks like on the phone. There's a free app, and it's not going to want to. It's hard to tell with this lighting. Here we go. These are the last pictures that I printed out. It shows you everything that you have on your phone. It brings up all your albums. And I'm going to pick out two pictures to print. There's my grandson. He lost his second tooth down there at the bottom tonight. So I am going to choose that one, and then I am going to go to the effects at the bottom, and I'm going to split this so I can put two pictures on one. This lighting looks really weird. It doesn't actually look like this on my phone. It's much clearer. This is showing like a lot of contrast there. Let's pick another picture to add to it. And I'm going to pick this one. So I have two pictures on it. So it's going to print out these two pictures on one sheet of paper. And you can go up to, you can't see these down here, but it shows you all the different configurations. There's several different ways that you can add pictures to here. And a lot of times this last one here is four pictures. And that's, I usually put four pictures on one 2x3 sheet. So I can get four pictures on this one sheet of paper. For this, I'm just going to do these two. I'm going to go back so it saves that for me. I'm going to turn on my printer. I wait for the light to stop blinking. And then I can just set it on here and it automatically sends it to there. And it says it's starting to print. I'm going to take it off so you can see that. My grandson looks really funny in this picture. He's 5 years old and losing his bottom teeth, finally. Already, I should say. Seems like it's too soon to me. Here comes the picture. Now, it's not the greatest print quality, but I don't expect that from a little pocket printer that I can take with me everywhere and print pictures directly from my phone. If I want really good quality pictures, then I'm going to send them off to get printed somewhere. Or do it online and get them from Walgreens or Walmart or somewhere and have some nice photos printed out. But there it is. And you don't have to worry about touching it. It's dry. No issues with that. So I'm going to get my scissors. Let me turn this off. And I'm just going to cut it. Sometimes I leave them together like a collage. Just cut it, and then you just peel the back. Like if you're peeling off a sticker. And I'm going to put this on today. Because here's today, and he lost his tooth tonight. And then this one. I'm going to stick here on this side. I scoot it over. As this goes with the video that I did earlier on the update on my bullet journal. And that goes there. And it's just that easy. I love this thing. This is probably the best thing that I have bought this past year. I've had it almost right at a year now. And I use it all the time. It's the best investment that I have made this entire year. Even with all the planners, everything that I have purchased, this is probably the number one item off of the entire list of things that I purchased for the year. I just love it that much, and I use it so much. So it was a really good buy, considering how much I actually use it. I have things that I don't ever use or touch again that I should probably sell, but I love it. If y'all have any questions about this, just let me know below in the comment section, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. That's it, guys. Y'all have a great day, and I will see you next time.